You know, I get it. The S24 Ultra just dropped and you want to soak in that vibe first. Talking about the Galaxy S25 Ultra already seems too soon, right? But guess what? Tech moves fast and there's some cool stuff happening with the S25 Ultra that I'd like to share with you. So hear me out. You see, when Qualcomm unveiled the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 for the S24 Ultra a few months ago, they also mentioned that starting with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 4, which will end up on the S25 Ultra, they're gonna shift to the Orion cores. What is an Orion core, you ask? Well, it's basically a new CPU core, but it's a game changer for Qualcomm and Samsung. You see, back in January 2021, Qualcomm bought a company called Nuvia, which was founded by former Apple engineers renowned for creating Apple M-series chips. Fast forward to October last year, Qualcomm revealed that these cores outshine the latest Apple M chip in performance while being considerably more energy efficient. Although initially introduced in the PC version, the company also disclosed plans to integrate Orion cores into the Snapdragon 8 Gen 4. Today we've got a leaked benchmark score to give you a sneak peek at what this chip can do. First things first, this chip is made using TSMC's 3-nanometer nodes, and the rumors claim that Qualcomm has made significant strides with CPU performance potentially rivaling Apple's M-series chips, let alone their A-series chips. So on Geekbench 6, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 4 is about to hit over 2800 points in the single core test and crush 10,000 points in the multi-core test. That's a first for any mobile, getting so close to, let alone crossing the 10,000 mark. Let me throw in some context. Check out the scores for the S24 Ultra and the iPhone 15 Pro Max. It's like a massive performance gap, no kidding. But wait, there's more. It's pulling off these scores with just 8 watts of power compared to its predecessor's 11 watt. That's a big jump in power efficiency. And here's the cherry on top. Word is the Adreno A30 GPU inside is supposedly 10% more powerful than Apple's desktop-grade M2 chip. We all know Apple has been dominating the chip game for the past decade with its A-series chips, but things have been shaking up lately. This year, the 8 Gen 3 caught up in CPU performance with the latest A-series chip. Now, Orion cores might just be the last thing Qualcomm needs to outshine Apple. Now check out this crazy rumor making the rounds. Word on the street is Samsung is going all in with the Exynos chip for the Galaxy S25 lineup. I mean, this tipster claims Samsung's planning to exclusively use Snapdragon chip for their foldables, go full on Exynos in the S series, and mix it up with MediaTek and Exynos in the A series phones. But hold up, before you start losing your mind, let me drop some truth bombs. I can tell you with absolute certainty, like 100%, that this ain't gonna happen. Samsung just renewed their deal with Qualcomm, promising to stick with Snapdragon chip for the foreseeable future. Plus, it would be downright crazy to ditch Qualcomm when they're sitting pretty at the top. So don't fall for this unfounded rumor, it's just noise. Anyway, Samsung might just make our dreams come true with the Z Fold 6 by dropping an Ultra model. Click here to know more, and I'll see you there.